Hi, today we're going to be finishing this case. This is the front plate to the case, and this is the back plate to the case. What you're going to need is some rhinestones and some pearls. And for the front case, just rhinestones and pearls. But for the back case, I took old jewelry. Like, this came from a ring, this came from a bracelet, an earring, and earrings. Also, what you're gonna need is some E6000 glue. This is clear, it dries clear and goes on clear. So, what we're gonna do here is, for whatever tool you have, I usually use a pencil or an eyeliner, but I don't like this one because it gets on my pearls. So I'm going to take my tool and get a little bit on there. I don't want all of that because it's going to be all gunky. So now you're going to take this glue that you have on there and spread it out. Amongst the area that you're working with, you can make sure you get a lot on there. Don't be afraid to use a lot of glue because it's going to dry up and get small anyway. Okay, so now you can close up your glue so it doesn't dry out. So your next step is to take it, get you a rhinestone on your thing, and place it wherever you want to go, like this. And I'm doing a multicolored case, so I'm just placing them wherever as I go along. Since it's going to be a personal case, I mean, it really doesn't have to be that fancy for me. And this glue is really good glue. Don't be afraid if it gets on anything because it can rub right off. So just take any color rhinestones. As you see, I'm just picking up any kind of colors. And just placing them on there. And make sure you get you some pretty colored, multicolored pearls. Because the pearls really do make it look very pretty. Those pearls are stuck together, so put those on there together. And you want to do it kind of quick because the glue does tend to dry quickly. I get this on there, and the case comes together pretty. It looks very pretty as an end result. They make good birthday presents, Christmas presents, or just a good DIY for yourself if you like to do these types of things. We can see how it's kind of together. Looks pretty nice. Get it up close. See. Now I'm going to take this rhinestone and place it up here in between the pearl and the other one.
I'm gonna get another rhinestone. Now I'm gonna start working on the bottom half. Because as you can see, it's coming together pretty nice. It's like a junk case. Has a lot of different pretty things on it.
I want to show you all how that goes. And I'm gonna get another pearl, and you wanna place that right there. That's it. With a rhinestone, and since my rhinestones are fairly small, I can take them and place them anywhere where I see that it may be a little crack or something where you can't really see. And I don't mind the pink case showing. That way it gives it a little background color. But if you don't, you could get different color, different size rhinestones. But since I have a pink case, I really don't mind the pink case showing. For my back part of my phone case, I'm going to actually go back in with some of my pearls. Because I just got them, so I'm trying them out to see how I like them, see if I'll order some more. And I actually got the rhinestones and the pearls off of eBay. And when doing projects like these, you really have to have patience, because they do take up a lot of time. But don't be discouraged, because in the end, you're left with a really pretty result. And a lot of people will want to know where you got your case from. And you can be as creative as you would like.
So this is how my top corner looks. I'm not finished with it yet, but once I do finish the whole entire case, I'll be coming back with another tutorial on how I do the back part of my case. Alright, thank you for watching. Bye.